Okay, so I'm going to start the paint now. I'm going to do the sky first. I'm going to start with the. I got some. This first one, I'll tell you what I'm using here. This is a 14 flat Simply Simmons brush. I think it's a stiff. It's more stiff. I didn't really want that. I was kind of hoping to get a softer brush, but it's not bad. I mean, I'm just putting the base coat anyway. I also have to go around these. There's a lot of trees in this painting, so what I have to do is. But I mean, obviously, I'm gonna paint over it. I'm gonna have to because where I know there is a branch, which is right here, I'm gonna go around it. But so I got white and ultramarine blue. I'm just gonna put it on thick for now. A little water would be good, actually. Yeah, I want to make it thinner, that's true. There you go. Get some lines going here. Oh, I'm gonna fix this after, of course. Base of the sky mostly. Some more white and blue. We get a little more dark blue up top here. And there's going to be trees over here around this area. Be a clean sky too, so I'll make it a little cleaner looking just by going one direction. Doesn't have to be, but some more water and I put some more white and blue. Tell you what, I'm gonna go down. Ew, missed that one, but okay. I'm gonna go down to the roof line. Try to be more careful next time. Try to take some of these lines out for now. I could always put them back later. Let's try to wipe that off. All right, I hit the roof line. Of course, I'm gonna. Just a little more right there. That's all right. That's exactly where I want it, actually. That's right here. Okay. I'll call that in after. This is basically the blocking in stage, so I'm just blocking in the sky for now. I should do the same in case, well, again, I'm going to be going over this, so, in case I miss any areas. a lot of trees down here and over here, so there's no sky on that end. Just a little shining through here, and that's it. Not sure how big this tree is. Okay. Can't really see it in the picture, so. Okay. So there's the sky. Just making the roof line. Just an idea of where these, just the texture of the shingles kind of, that's all. Some areas will be darker than others. Okay, let me try. shadows over here. Take that off a little bit. Yeah, I'm gonna put some shadow in there. Need something. A little water, it's gonna dry. Just finish these little bricks and stuff. It's all asphalt and stuff, so. I'll redo this. Yeah. put the black over it after. This is just a lighter coat. I'm gonna get some, I got brown, blue, green, and black. I'm making a very dark color for the base of the trees. There's gonna be, the trees are all starting here. Not in there, okay. It's like this. This is just a base, but there are. A lot of trees over here, so, and it goes off the screen, I can't really see, so I'm just going to do the same thing. All right, mix some blue, brown, green, keep it all different. I'm not just rolling it in, I'm just trying, because it will be light showing through here and there, so I don't want to mess that up too much. Just using a round brush right now. Number 12. Mixing up the tones a little bit by just mixing on the palette, brown, blue, green. I'm gonna put some yellow in there too. Yellow ochres. Trees everywhere on this. Very pretty. Okay, and we'll see through here on the side. A little more green over here. Blue, green, blue. Green. highlight these later on. I'm gonna bring this down since I'm let me move this just for now. Since I'm working on this side, so you can see it better. There we go. Diesel. Diesel. Well, this guy is almost all green. I mean, on the picture. Blue green, dark colors here and there. There's a lot of texture here, just dabs of on a round brush, just to give it some feeling, some. But I might just roll it out a little more. I don't know. Depends how it comes out. I'm experimenting with a new technique here, so it's always good to try something different. Basically, that's what it is. It's a bunch of, just leaves everywhere, you know? I have to put some branches, I understand, so I'm gonna get some brown and blues. straight yellow ochre over here. Straight yellow ochre up here. A few of them down here. That red, itty bitty little piece of red mixed in with it. There's some red up there. Some up here. That's it. Maybe some down here a little bit. Oh. I gotta put some green on there. Blue green. This is pretty much closed in here. Brown, blue, green. Yeah, too much brown. Too much brown. Oops. More green and blue. Side also. I get that going there. Yeah. cut. I gotta put the branches in, so I'll make this, this will make more sense. Oh yeah, right here I gotta put some dark green, a little brown, and this little pile here. I gotta break it up a little though. And this little guy here, this is gonna be a lot of yellow on that though too. So I like this one, that one's different. So I'm gonna get some white. That's good for that. This was a little different. This is green and white. This is like a potted plant, this one. Green with blue. No shadow area here. It's a little bit here. Show you that. Okay, so I just didn't have it plugged in this time around, so it ran out of battery. So I just started it up again, plugged it in, and I'm ready to go. All right, I'm just continuing doing the sky. All right, what do I want to do? Is let's try Mr. Bob Ross's line of brush. Where did I put that thing? That boy. I have one in there somewhere. I have a bunch of line of brushes, but I like his. Call me biased. All right, I have to find it first. So let me go look for that, and I'll be right back. All right, so I found the brush. Number two line of brush, Bob Ross. And I start putting in these branches so they stick out. And I got some brown and blue and green. I know I should have did this first, but I'm gonna have to go over that anyway, so. Plenty of water. All skinny little trees, little odd branches. Got some hanging down. Fix that. There's trees coming from behind these trees, of course, so it's kind of looks like it's coming out of this tree, but it isn't. Alright, don't want to overdo on that, just a few here and there. Highlights. Now, I could use a fan brush too, but I don't know if I want to mix it right now. No, I think I'm going to use the same brush I used. Alright, the number 12 round brush. Alright, I'm going to get in some color. Different yellows and well, actually, some white. Right here, there's a few different color there. And up here. It's in the dark areas. Some over here. There were a couple of branches right there I missed. Okay, let me put them in. Just a couple. Looks like it was coming out of the chimney, but That's what I'm seeing here, though. Oops. Some lighter ones for the distant ones in the background. There we go. So I'm trying to get the look of the picture. You can basically, there's a bunch of patches of dark, and then there's some light spots where you can see through. Mostly you can see through. So, and the sky basically can't see at all. I mean, just a hint of the sky, which is what I have now. So, that's why I wasn't worried about the sky. All right. Some over here. There's a couple of good ones here. Light hitting the back of these here. A little yellow there, not too much, just like that. And again, there's some here. Any different? Let's try this way there. All right. All kind of mixes in. I think that's good for the sky. So, well, all right, I'm going to put in the color. It's basically an off. I'm going to put the very light color. Let's see what I got here. So I got the unbleached titanium white. Unbleached titanium. That's what it is. That's what I'm using. I'm gonna use that for the color of the house. A simple round brush. I square off all these little soft lines. This is where you do it. Just blocking in the color now. Very quiet here because it's tricky. I can't see that well, so glasses get in my way. I don't know. I never can get used to glasses. I had contacts for many years, but then I had developed floaters at a young age, and I didn't know it. So I did a test, and I had LASIK surgery. Yes, I got 20/20 vision, but it lost my night vision. I had no night vision after that. I mean, no night vision. Very poor night vision. I used to see in the dark much better, you know. It's almost like it takes away your visual purple or your, I don't know, your eyes don't constrict or dilate as good. Something's wrong. But that's one of the, I didn't know that was an after effect of the LASIK. And I was told that after. So, yeah, that's one of the side effects. And I'm like, whoa, I didn't know that. Well, that's my fault. Not for anything. I could do okay. It's just that it's tricky driving at night and stuff. With the headlights on and all that, that's fine. So it's not that bad. But I'm talking about, you know, I'm just talking about the seeing at night. I used to be able to see crystal clear at night. But anyway, so I did the test and it didn't come out too good. I thought I'd be able to see better. And to my dismay, I did not. I mean, yeah, sure, I don't need glasses to see, you know, distance, but now I need glasses to read all the time. I cannot see anything. Again, that's one of the side effects, so I didn't know that. I'm sorry, I knew that, but I figured I had to try because I had intermittent vision. I thought it was my contacts. You know, I thought the contacts were always dirty, and it wasn't really the case, so I got to get in these little spots. They're gonna be clean. This will look like a messy house. Oh, that is siding. I'm sorry. Yes, under there too. That's gonna be a little darker, maybe. And then right here. I thought that was white, but now it's not. So I did take my daughter to get some. She had a gift certificate. She has a lot of gift certificates. They gave her a lot of those so she can buy her own stuff. She likes to buy clothes. She's 12. She's going to be a teenager soon. Well, in May. More than half a year, but I'm going to push it. Ariana, yeah, she's a... Whew, she's doing good. She's very nice. Good little girl. Very good kid. Very lucky. I also have two other daughters and one other son. And this is my son's house with his new with his fiance, Christina. She's awesome. Can't wait. They're gonna get married soon, and they bought a house together, and this is it. As I mentioned earlier, in case you didn't hear it, catch that part of the video, because this is probably going to be a long video. I mean, it is going to be a long video. Definitely going to be a long video. I'm going to have to tomorrow finish this up, I think. All right, so I'm going to pause the video here. And we'll take it tomorrow and start a fresh day. Okay. I'll see you then. Well, I guess I can finish the top. I didn't do this part. My bad. Ew. That's really it. There's a little line underneath. It's shadow though. Okay. Check it all. Yeah, it's good enough for now. Alright, we'll see you later. I'm going to be doing some of the lines in the siding here. Just the detailed small little areas. Just the shadow areas, obviously, so that's what I want to try. See how this works out. I'm going to use a little liner brush and a T-ruler so I can get this straight. And the problem is this hole, as you can see, it's off up here into there because it was skewed when the picture was taken and when I traced it onto the canvas from the projector, that's how it came out. So it's literally a little off. So I have to compensate with the T-ruler. So I'm just going to do that the same all the way down and be fine. So I'm going to start from here. Like that. I'm going to get a small brush. I'm going to try it with this smaller detail brush. It's very small. I can't even read the writing on it. It's kind of worn off. So sorry about that. But I'm going to use some gray paint that I mixed up. Some black, and actually I have to make some more. I'm just gonna try a little bit of just a little here, see if this works. Do a little test. I just have to kind of like go straight across. Yeah, I guess this is the man. I'm not gonna be doing it against the ruler. I'm just gonna be using it so you can see. I won't be able to see that. All right. I'm going to mix some more up, more paint. I got some different shades of gray here. It's nothing to do with that movie, Shades of Gray. No joke there. All right, this is not going to work. It's too thick. I can see it. Yeah, I don't like that at all. Try this differently. Let's see if I can fix that. Okay. On the side here, I have to zoom out. There's a light here or something, so I'll just stop it right there. Daughter out, get her car fixed. My Brittany, other daughter, not Ariana, obviously. Ariana's only 12, so she's not gonna get a car anytime soon. So, but Brittany, she's like, whoa, she's gonna be 30, I think. What was it, 29? She's 29, I believe. Yeah. Let's see. Back to her in 1 second. Just want to do this. See in there anyway, so that's pretty much done right here. Okay. I'll have to continue later. I need this.